Hello, my name is Jakob Miksch, and today with my
And
colleague Christian Meyer, we will present you something about Wegue, a software with which you can do web mapping with OpenLayers and Vue.js. So about myself, so I am a geospatial developer working at Maximum, and Christian Meyer is the founder of Maximum, also a geospatial software developer and architect working for several open source projects like GeoStyle, GeoX, this presenter and trainer, and also OSGeo charter member. Our company Maximum provides services in the field of GIS, web mapping, SDI. We do tailored web GIS solutions, software development, everything with geodata, and also provide consulting and training. The software Wegue is basically a combination of Vue.js and OpenLayers, which I will explain in a minute. So it's basically a lightweight template for web maps. So the idea is that you can quickly create a web map with all your layers and modules you would like to have. It's rather thought for having single purpose apps and not like a fully fledged WebGIS. It's of course open source. You can find the code on GitHub, and there's a separation of custom code, which you can customize by yourself and tailor it to your needs, and also of the core code. Non-goals are we don't want to become a pure library, which we would just like to stay a template for a new WebGIS projects. Then we don't want to become a desktop GIS for the browser, and we won't like to avoid feature creep, so basically overloading the UI with too many features so that the users don't know what's happening anymore. So we would like to keep it user friendly and simple and easy to use. One important thing about Wegue is that you can actually get a lot of functionality already without any coding. You just need to edit the JSON, like the configuration file, which is basically a JSON. There you can define the color of the application, the title, then all of your layers, for example, WMS, WFS, GeoJSON, vector ties, whatsoever. You can provide the names, if they should be visible or not, if they're a base layer or not. So a lot of things that you typically need in a web map can be defined in the configuration file. And additionally, you can activate some modules, which I will explain later on. And if you need something specific, there is a part in the application where you can provide your own code, your own components, and where you can adapt it. And the idea is that there's a core part of the application which you don't have to touch, and there's an extra app directory where you can provide your own code, so you can easily upgrade the application with when there's a new version, and just keep your custom code in a separate directory. And of course you can do both, so you can define your app with the configuration file and also additionally code by yourself. All right, so let's get to the foundation of Wegue. So we use OpenLayers for map rendering, which is a very established library for displaying all of kind of geodata in the browser. And Vue.js is a web framework. It's currently one of the most used web frameworks. So there's also React.js and Angular. And Vue.js is a bit younger, and it's has a really wide adoption. Meanwhile, a very big ecosystem, and it's known to be a bit simpler to learn. And we have very good experience with it. And for the user interface, we use Vuetify, which is a component framework for Vue.js. Hello, my name is Jakob Miksch, and today
Let me try to
edit
go
the
further.
Code, your own components. There's a very established library for most used.
Yes.
It's a really wide adoption, meanwhile, a very big ecosystem, and it's known to be a bit simpler to learn. And we have very good experience with it. And for the user interface, we use Vuetify, which is a component framework for Vue.js, building upon a material design, has a really wide adoption, and it's of course also open source, like Vue.js as well. And there we get our UI element, so there's a lot of things provided out of the box. So, for example, like buttons, checklists, windows, tables, lists, you can all get in with Vuetify and have a really consistent and nice design. So here's a little animation of how Wegue can look like. So here we have a layer tree, you have a map, you can switch on layers on and off. So basically all the standard things that you expect from a web map since many years. And so this is not something extremely surprising, but the nice part about Wegue is that you can just activate all these functionalities out of the box with a configuration file. And now I will show you just some really basic features that Wegue has that you can activate. So we have a base map switcher. So in your configuration file, you can just define which of your layers are base maps and which are not, and then they will show up in this base map switcher. Then we have, of course, an overlay switcher where your overlays are can be switched on and off. Then a measure tool for area and distance. So again, this is nothing innovative or super fancy. It's just we have it, and you can activate it just with one little setting in your configuration file, so there's no need to implement something new. Then a geocoder component is included because this is needed very often. Help window, which you can easily add your own content with your own text and links. Then you can click on features and you get an information. Then if you would like to have, you can add your components or modules. You can either put it to the toolbar or you can put it to the sidebar. This is up to you and can also be defined in a configuration file. Then we have an attribute table for vector layers where you can scroll through the layers and click on a row, and then it will jump to the respective feature on the map. Then a rather innovative feature is a map recorder, where you can click on record, then do something on the map, zoom, pan, and go to a specific location, then stop your recording, and this recording will be saved as a video file on your computer, which can be really cool from time to time. But again, you don't need to use this feature. It's just like an option in your configuration file. You can switch on and off. Then we also have a QGIS plugin, which helps you to create an initial configuration file. So this makes it even easier. You just load all the layers you would like to have into QGIS, then provide some basic information that you would like to have, then also the modules you would like to activate. And then it creates a configuration file for you. Of course, we have some more features. So you have a selection tool that when you click on a feature, then something happens and you can actually define with code what will happen if you click on a specific feature. Typically use case would be that a window opens with some specific information. So for example, a chart displaying some measurement values of the specific feature. Then you can hover over features and get a tooltip. Then we also optimized Wegue for responsive design, so you can also display it nicely on your mobile phone. There's actually a lot of styling options, which you can also provide in the configuration file. Then there's a permalink in the URL, so you can copy your link, and when someone else pastes in again in the browser, it will directly show up at the specific location on the map where you pasted the link from. Then we have a documentation on Wegue.org. You can drag and drop geodata into the map, and we also have a multi-language support, so you can create for all the components, you can create different language texts for all parts which should be displayed. In the future, we would like to make the modules more generic and maybe extract some of them as a separate library, but still we would like to keep our app template approach, where you just can start off your web map with very low work at the beginning. So everything should be still available with the configuration file, and getting into creating a web map app should be really simple. Then just like a configuration file looks like. So this is a basic JSON where you have the key and the value, and you provide this. For example, here's a layer, and when you start the application, it will use the parts from the configuration file and build the application as you want it. To run your application, basically you download it with Git clone, install the dependencies, create your sample app, and then start a development server. Yeah, the only thing you need is to install Node.js on your machine. And finally, I would like to present you some demo applications. So in our documentation, we have a lot of them, which you can view. And here's one, it's the time viewer. So we added an additional component, which you can use for choosing a specific timestamp, and then the layer in the background is changing regarding to it. Then we have a point of interest viewer for a project where we are working on. It's called Sauber, and it's investigating the air quality, and here you have different stations and you can click on it, and then there's an image popping up. You get a diagram with the recent values and also some useful links. Then there's also a web map in collaboration with a partner of us, the company Geomare, which provides a map about rain and flood hazards. And when you click on the map, you can even see some flood animations, which are not part of Vuetify itself, but can easily edit because Vuetify is only the template, and you can add your own custom code and modifications if you like to it. Then finally, there's some links for a Vuetify project website, then the source code, of course, the gallery. And we also created a video tutorial, which should help you to set up your own Vuetify instance. And you can also get information on our company website. So this is just our general information. If you would like to see the slides or get a PDF of it, just click on the links below. And please let us know if you have any questions. Thanks for listening.
We had some issues, but we were able to play the video. Thank you for the authors. Kirsten is here, so we have some questions. So I would start with the most voted one. Is about supporting WMS and WFS services. Kirsten, can you
yes
say something?
So This was a tough ride, so sorry for inconvenience. We are supporting WFS and WFS out of the box, so you can add those layer types just by configuring it in the JSON file Jacob showed in the presentation. So provide a URL, layer name, feature type, and all that stuff, and then it works out of the box.
Okay, and another question is also related with the web processing services. Are you also able to use web processing services?
Not out of the box, so we do not have a module for that because WPS is just a, let's say, a cascade. So it's what should be done and what input and output types, you might need some kind of generic user interface. We do not have that, but what you always can do is integrate some JavaScript which communicates with your WPS. And then you can add the results to the map or something like that. The interfaces for that are there.
Okay. Another question was related with the availability of public sites using Wegue. But I think in the presentation, the last slides, we saw some pointers. But
yeah, and on Wegue.org, you have this gallery section where some applications are listed. And I will provide the link to the slides in the chat afterwards.
So and another question related with the support is does it support the OGC API features?
Not yet, but it's on our roadmap, and I think we have some kind of research project where it's one of the goals to interact with those new generation of OGC standards. So keep. Stay tuned. Something will happen in the near future, I guess, regarding OGC API.
Good to know. There is also a question that there is a Vue layers model already existing. So how this way compares with the Vue layers?
Vue layers, if I remember right, so I started the thing a couple of years ago, and if I remember right, Vue layers, I checked up front because I didn't want to reinvent the wheel, but Vue layers somehow wraps all the OpenLayers component into Vue components. So there is a Vue. So the approach is that you have Vue-like components for, let's say, for the map, for a layer, for all interactions of OpenLayers. And I did not like that, or that's too hard. But I thought to go another way, wrapping the map, and everything inside should be done with pure OpenLayers, because then I do not have this update stress. If something changes in OpenLayers, I have to update my code. If there is a new interaction, I have to wrap it as well. Then I'm always in this kind of never-ending wheel. So I thought, okay, keep the power where it is initially. And if you want to do something with OpenLayers, you do it with normal JavaScript OpenLayers code.